Good morning students. Today we are going to study about the third and fourth defect of vision. First and second we have studied hypermetropia and second was myopia. Today we are going to study about the third and fourth defect of vision. Here you can see it is the third one is presbyopia, which is also called as aging eye. Okay, mostly this defect is seen in the old age peoples. Okay, what happens over here? Presbyopia means it is a, your eye becomes aging, means some changes occurs in your eyes, so that what happened that it causes the defect. First one is reduced near vision. Means what? As in last video I have explained you that old people, they cannot see or they cannot read keeping the book 25 centimeter away from their eyesight. Okay, so it is due to the aging of the eye. Great. So reduce near vision. Then you have seen if old peoples are in your house, your grandfather, grandmother, they cannot read properly without their glasses or without their specs. They cannot read. They have to use the specs to read properly. Okay, means because of the aging of eye, in this age if you will see what happens, they cannot means even if they are keeping at 35 centimeter to 40 centimeter, they cannot read it. Means they have to use the specs or glasses for reading. Now see the fatigue after a short period. This also mostly you can see in old people, if they are doing some close work, if they are very closely, if they are some observing continuously or doing any close work related to our eyes, what happens after some time, they feel fatigue. Okay, so these are the symptoms of aging of our eye. Okay, these are the main symptoms what happens and why it happens, why this happens or what happens over here. So here this it is given that loss of flexibility and relaxation or elasticity. Means what? If you see the eye of young persons, okay, they are very soft and elastic. Now elasticity, why it should be there? Elasticity should be there for the lens, so that what happened, it can change its shape, it can change the shape to focus the light rays. Okay, so this purpose, your eye should be where your lens should be softer and it should be having good elasticity, so that it can easily focus or it can change its focal length properly. For this purpose elasticity should be there, proper elasticity, and this is found in the young age person's eyes. So as it becomes older, what happens, your eyes loses the elasticity and it also loses the flexibility, and because of this what happens, presbyopia. Okay, and what happens then, because of this your eye adjustment loses. Means what? Adjustment of eye loses means the light ray is just falling on our eye screen, that it loses. Okay, because of this aging purpose. And after 40 what happens, lens become rigid. As I have told you, young people have very healthy eye with a flexibility, good flexibility, good softness, so that to adjust, and elasticity also. But the persons after age of 40, if you will see their eye lens, it start becoming rigid. Rigid means there is no elasticity in this lens, then how it can focus properly on the retina? It cannot be focused. Okay, for that purpose elasticity should be there in our lens, eye lenses. Okay, for and it loses when the person become old, the elasticity loses and the lens become rigid. So this was the third defect, which is called as presbyopia. It is also called as aging disease or aging eye. Okay, now actually these are the defects of our visions. And now fourth one is astigmatism. Astigmatism means this is a defect related to our lens and cornea. Cornea, as you know, this is the outer part which is called as cornea, and behind that cornea what happens, lens is there. So it is a disease, it is a defect, not disease, it is a defect related to cornea and lens. Okay, and it is called as astigmatism. In this what happens, the person sees a blurred vision. the object or the image which the person may see, that is blurred. He cannot see a clear vision. Okay, then what happened? The cornea is not curved. If you see this cornea, how curved it is, properly curved. But in astigmatism, this cornea is not properly curved. It is not properly curved. There is some defects in this curvature. If you will see, what happens? Suppose this half part is curved and half is little bit inside, or it comes outside. Okay, so it is not properly curved. So this is also symptoms of this disease, of this defect. Light rays do not focus correctly on retina, and because of this, what happens? Because of the defect in cornea, light, there is a problem. Or if even though there is a problem in lens or defect in lens, light ray will not properly reach to the retina. So what happened? And if it is not reaching it properly on retina, it may go behind, it may come front of the retina. And because of this, what happens? Because of this, you can see a blurred image. Now, next you can see, it is also caused by irregular shaped lens. Now you know, as it is a convex lens, if there is irregularity in this lens, then also you can see the blurred image, means this image. It is very important. This astigmatism, this defect is related to cornea and lens. So if any defect is there in this both, this defect is identified in that person. Okay, so one more thing, this two types, this astigmatism is, two types of astigmatism is found, defect is found. If the defect is related to cornea, it is called as corneal astigmatism. Very simple, if any defect is there in cornea, it is called as corneal astigmatism. And if any defect is present in this lens, it is called as lenticular astigmatism. Okay, these are just two types. Just for your understanding, I have explained you these two types. Actually, you don't have in your study, but for your understanding, if it is related to lens, it is lenticular, related to cornea, it is corneal astigmatism. These are the two types. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.